President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. has approved the merger of state-run banks, Land Bank of the Philippines and the Development Bank of the Philippines, despite opposing this in 2016. Finance Secretary Benjamin Jokno said this move was prompted by recent financial developments abroad.
We're not saying that the current system is broken, but as policymakers, we have to constantly seek better ways of doing things, no? Especially if we want to improve the performance of particular government agencies. And this is also consistent with our right-sizing.
The merger will create a bank that is bigger than BDO Unibank in terms of assets, according to the finance chief. He adds, with the merger, the operating cost will be lower.
The projected operating cost savings due to the merger could reach at least 5.3 billion per year. So for the next 4 years, at least 20 billion.
According to the Banco Central, BDO is the largest bank in the Philippines in terms of assets as of last year. This is followed by Land Bank of the Philippines. The Development Bank of the Philippines is at the 8th spot.
And that's really the best practice. The biggest bank usually is owned by the state globally. The merged bank will be stronger. And in fact, one likely outcome of this is that maybe the interest rate that they will charge will be lower. The plan is that Land Bank will have a branch in all LGUs in the Philippines. Okay, it could be a combination of light branches or big branches, ATMs, etc.
Land Bank currently has 752 branches nationwide, while DBP has 147 branches, but only 22 branches will be retained. Jokno admits the merger will cause some workers to lose their jobs, but he says government is willing to offer attractive separation and early retirement packages.
Voluntary, and then they can choose to retire. And since they are government official, they can retire under GSIS, or we will offer an attractive package for those who will be separated.
When he was still running for vice president, Marcos opposed the merger, saying it will harm the country's farming sector. He also argued then that if the merger happens, it will become a commercial bank, which can potentially remove Land Bank's ability to provide loans for agribusiness and other financing support to farmers and farmers' cooperatives. Jokno explains the president's change of heart.
Nag-change talaga yung ano niya kasi given, sabi ko nga, yung international developments, di ba? Big banks are folding, etc. Plus, no, he hasn't changed his mind since he was elected president. I know that he was for this proposal.
At least one senator has expressed concern over the merger. Senator Sherwin Gatchalian says merging the two banks will create a super monopoly that would affect the interest of farmers and local government units.
Dahil may monopoly siya ng LGU deposits eh. At dati nakakapili pa yung mga LGUs between Land Bank or DBP, ngayon isa na lang. At wala silang choice. So kung masama ang servisyo ng super monopoly, wala silang choice. Mataas ang interest rate sa kanilang loans, wala silang choice. So it's bad for our local government.
But for a market analyst, the merger makes sense.
We've seen that a lot of these mergers and acquisitions for banks are quite positive in effect. You have larger assets. I think is better management and control. Perhaps also with the professionals who are in charge as well.
The merger is expected to take effect by the end of the year. Job Manahan, ABS-CBN News.